On a tree by a river, a little tomtit sang willow, tit willow, tit willow.
Oh, the doing and undoing, oh, the sighing and the snoring.
I am very good at integral and differential calculus. I know the scientific names of beings and animalculus. In short, in metals, vegetable, animal, and mineral, I am the very model of a modern major general.
Not since 1982, when they went out of business, have any of Gilbert and Sullivan's operas been performed by the Dolly Cart Company. Its traditional style of presentation just seemed to go out of fashion. But today, to a fanfare from Iolanthe, the Dolly Cart Opera Company was relaunched. Thanks to a £1.4 million legacy from Dame Bridget Dolly Cart, the daughter of the company's founder, a six-figure gift from British Midland Airways, and donations from the Dolly Cart Opera Trust, the company is back in business. They've got a permanent chorus together, as well as some lead singers, and they've got promises of help from the Actors' Union Equity and even from the Musicians' Union when it comes to negotiating fees. It'll start by touring the country with two of G&S's favourite works, Iolanthe and The Yeoman of the Guard, though so far its only confirmed scheduled visit to the southeast will be at Crawley's Hall Theatre at the end of May. Yet why should the new company be successful now when the old one wasn't?
I'm sure that we're going to be as successful as the old company, and that saw them through 107 years. To be more successful would be splendid. I'm sure that that can be achieved because the theatrical scene has changed. It's very exciting nowadays with a lot of big musicals. But remember that G&S is effectively the longest lasting pop repertoire in the world.
You said that you've been a fan of Gilbert and Sullivan since you were 11, I think it was. What is it about Gilbert and Sullivan operas that grabs you?
I think The Yeoman of the Guard, for example, has some absolutely super music in it. But it's a unique combination of wonderfully hummable music and superb words. The trouble with most operettas and light pieces of that kind is that the script is usually absolutely appalling. And Gilbert was a master, a real master. They're classics, and I think they'll probably last in the way that, say, Restoration comedy has lasted for a very, very long time.
Then to the somewhat appropriate music of Sir Arthur Bliss's fanfare Things to Come, the toast was to the success of the new enterprise. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.